Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Rajat.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah.
So what is your profession?
I'm a competitive cyclist. I want to be a pro cyclist one day. I want to be a pro world tour rider.
What made you want to be a cyclist?
It's the pain and suffering. Like for me, like the pain is real that cycling gives me. Like it's a humbling pain and the it's really like it's like a mirror in your face. So basically you can gauge yourself every day, like where you stand. Like there's no lying, no deception. So it's just point blank truth in right in front of your face. So that's what I love about cycling. And also that pain factor is really gratifying.
Do you think you can be a good cyclist on a vegan diet?
Yeah, of course. Like I've seen wonders after being vegan. Like it's just not the performance. And like initially I turned vegan like only for performance and health related reasons. But later on, like I got enlightened about a lot of things, like the animal cruelty, like the environmental factor, the sustainability of the entire universe. So all that things goes into me being a vegan.
So what do your family and friends think of you going vegan?
I've really found a lot of resistance with family and friends. Like my mom herself is a cancer survivor, so I keep on educating her, and I've lost many uncles and aunts owing to cancer and all these things. So I keep on educating them, but there's never been a positive response. However, like people around me, like as athletes and other people who look up to me, like they have always questioned me, like as in, what do you do? Like, how are you so agile, fast, and fit, and all these things? So I preach a word or two about veganism.
Do you think like more celebrities and like people in sport should promote veganism?
Yeah, of course. Like that's a part of educating, like reaching the greater mass, because most of the common man, like they buy into celebrities and people with political power or, you know, diplomats.
What other ways can we promote veganism to people?
For example, there are many ways, like just being an example, like living example. Like me, for example, as an athlete, like suppose when I perform like really at a high level, I perform very well and all. So they ask me about like, how do you maintain this, like this kind of performance and you don't fall sick and all these things. So for example, I had an event like three months back. So it was basically a tour in the Indian, like the Southern India. So it was an 8-day event. So out there, like I didn't actually go about people saying that I'm a vegan, but they somehow got to know, and they asked me like, what do you do? Like, how did you turn vegan? And why did you turn vegan? So it got me the chance to explain them and educate them.
Do you have like a special diet?
I keep on researching a lot. So I'm quite OCD about stuff. So recently, like 2 months back, I turned fruitarian. Like I would say I'm not a complete fruitarian. Like I follow the 80-10-10 diet. So 95% of my diet comes from fruits. Like I read a lot on Dr. Doug Graham and all of them. So like there's a lot of research into it. So I do the best thing for me and the planet.
Is it an expensive diet to be a fruitarian?
You just need to work out. Like there's always a way around. So you just need to find that way. It's very simple actually.
Why do you think there's more females than males that are vegan?
I think females are more compassionate than males. I mean, it's said like biologically, like females, like a female who is 5 years younger than a male of the same age, she is 5 times, in fact, elder in terms of emotions and emotional maturity. So I think it's again the same thing that works in society as well, like the maturity part and the compassion.
So how can we like encourage more guys to go vegan?
More guys, like I tried going through the ethical part, like, but it doesn't work for most of the guys who I stay with, like who I hang around with. So they are like more into performance and all. So the way for me to turn them vegan is basically take the path of performance and health, and then slowly enlighten them about the ethical side of it. So finally, like either way, you turn them vegan.
Why did you become vegan?
I became vegan by watching Gary Yourofsky's lecture. So it was one of his speeches at some US school or something. So it was like that just opened my eyes and I turned vegan overnight. Like prior to that, I was into like a keto diet. Like I was basically into bodybuilding and all. So I really used to be big and bulky. So over the past months, my challenge has been to be really lean. Like I want to be like a greyhound, like the ideal African physique, like the African runner physique. So vegan diet has ideally brought me down to that. So yeah, like Gary Urofsky, like he's basically the guy who turned me vegan overnight.
That's good.
And then I watched Earthlings, but I could not watch it because it was too fierce for me.
Do you have any tips for people that want to go vegan?
Yeah, I've turned a few of my friends and like there are potential people around me like who wants to go vegan. So hopefully they will go vegan.
And do you have any advice for them?
Be open. Like most of them are really shut down as per their perspective is concerned, so they don't want to get educated and they just ignore. So the thing is to be open-minded and keep on learning stuff every day, because there's scope for improvement every day.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. You're welcome.